Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here, and in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can accept user input using C++. Let's get into it. Computer programs are usually a two-way street. They accept user input, they do something with that input, and they produce output. Not always, but most of the time. So up until now, we have only been displaying output without accepting any user input. But today, that's all going to change because I'll show you how. What we can do is that we can accept user input and store it within a variable that we can use later on in our program. So to begin, we'll want to create a variable, and for our example, let's create a string variable simply named name. So we'll say string name, and we don't necessarily need to assign this variable a value right away. We can simply just declare it without assigning it. So effectively, this variable will not contain any value until we enter in some user input, and that user input will be assigned to this variable later on in this program. So next, we'll want to create a cout statement that will function as a prompt to let the user know that we want them to enter in their name. So we'll use the cout statement, and let's create a prompt such as, please enter your name. All right, and this is what you do if you want to accept user input. You need to type cin for input, and next you need to use the extraction operator, which is two right angle brackets, and then you're going to put your variable here. So in our case, it's going to be name. So this is what you do to assign user input. Next, we can use this variable elsewhere in our program, so now we can display a message using another cout statement that includes our variable. So we can say, welcome name. So let's try this out and see if it works. All right, so let's run this. So here's our prompt, please enter your name. So here I'm going to type in bro and hit enter, and it says, welcome bro, and that was our user input that we entered in. So going back to our code, I'd like to show you guys something. Now, with the cout statement, you'll notice a pattern. We say cout for output, then we use the insertion operator, and then we write whatever we want to display as output. Then with input, we do something kind of like the opposite. We write cin for input, then we use the extraction operator, which is two right angle brackets instead of two left angle brackets, and then we write something to function as input. It's kind of like the cout and the cin statements are kind of opposites. We have cout and cin, output input. We have the insertion operator, which is two left angle brackets, and the extraction operator, which is two right angle brackets. And then for cout, we have the output that we want, and for cin, the input that we want. So you're also not limited to only using strings as variables. For example, let's create an int, which is an integer, and we can change this to perhaps age. And we can say, please enter your age. And we will change name to age. And for our output, we'll say something such as, your age is whatever we enter in. All right, so let's try this out. It's going to be the same process, basically. Please enter your age. I'll just make up an age and say I'm 18. Hit enter, and it says your age is 18. So you can enter in whatever sort of data type that you need. So one problem that you may encounter in the beginning stages of your programming career is that if somebody enters in input that's not of the type that you anticipate, for example, for our prompt here, it says please enter your age. And if I don't enter a number and put a word here, such as pizza, because that's the first thing that comes to mind, and hit enter, it's actually going to cause an unexpected result and sometimes cause an exception. So later on in a future lesson, we're going to cover exception handling, where we can prevent people from doing things such as this and take corrective actions. So in the meantime, you just have to be sure that you're entering in information that is of the correct data type that you're anticipating. All right, so there's another type of input function that you guys should be aware of, and I'll give you guys a scenario. So what I'm going to do is reverse all these changes back to when we entered in our name. All right, so let's run this and I'll show you an example. All right, so let's say that we enter in a first name and a last name, and I'll just enter in a last name that I make up, like Bro Washington. And then I'll hit enter. All right, so you can see that it actually didn't enter in my last name. It wasn't stored within that name variable because when we use this cin statement, it stops at any blank space. Cin considers any white spaces as terminating characters, so that means we can only use this to assign a single value or word without any white or empty spaces. So if we were to rerun this and we entered in this first name and last name all within one word, this would still work then, but any blank spaces are treated as terminating characters. So if you need to accept user input that will ignore spaces, there's a different form of user input that we need to use, and that is the getLine function that will read a line of text for us. So in order for us to use this getLine function, we need to include something at the top of our program. So we're going to, at the top, write include, then within a set of angle brackets, type in string. All right. So then what we'll do is we'll replace this cin statement with getLine, then a set of parentheses, and what we're going to type within here is first cin, comma, and then the name of the variable in which we want to store something, and then type a semicolon at the end. Then let's rerun this and see what our result is. So it says, please enter your name. So what if we typed in our full name? So Bro Washington, hit enter, and it now displays our entire full name despite there being a blank space between the first name and the last name. So you can use this getLine function to read an entire line of text. And it really doesn't matter the length. I'll just type in something that's insanely long and hit enter. And you can see that it read this entire line of text up until we hit enter. Just so you're aware, you can't use the getLine function for any data type that is of the integer, float, or double data type. For example, if I were to change name to an integer data type, this would not work. But the same thing would also apply to a char value, I guess. It would only apply to string data types because it reads a line of text. And basically, a string is one or more characters. It's basically like a line of text. You can think of it that way. So it's useful if you need to read a line of text that includes spaces. So that's the basics of accepting user input using C++. Now, if you're looking for practice or a project, what we're going to do is that we're going to create a program that's going to simulate a cash register where we can ring up an item and we'll actually accept user input. We'll ask the user what item they'd like to buy. We'll record a price, we'll have the user enter that in as well, a quantity, and then we'll generate like a final total or bill. So let's work on that program. Let's clear all this out and start over. All right, so if we want to write this program, we're going to want to declare all of our variables right away. So what we'll do is create a string and we'll call this item. What item do we want the user to buy, or what item will they enter in? We'll want a price. This will be a double value, so that's basically a decimal value for a price. We'll need a quantity. That could be a integer value. So we'll say int quantity. And lastly, a double value, which will function as the total, which is the total amount that the user has to pay. All right, so first we'll want to create a prompt that will ask the user what item they want to buy. So let's create a prompt using the cout statement, and we'll say, what item do you want to buy? All right, then we need to use the getLine function for this because the user input might include a space if they're entering in an item name. So we'll say getLine parentheses, we'll type cin, comma, then item because this is the item name. We're going to store the name of an item within here. All right, next we'll ask for a price. So we'll need another prompt. We'll say, what is the price for each? Then use whatever type of currency you want. I'll use American dollars. All right, and then we can use simply the cin statement for this. We don't need to use getLine. Cin price, and we can use the cin statement for double values. All right, so next we'll use the cout statement to ask for a quantity. How many do you want to buy? And then we'll use cin again and ask for the quantity, or store the quantity. Quantity, I can't spell. All right, and then lastly, we need to generate what the total price is gonna be, but first I'm going to add a end line just to give us some space after generating the total bill. So I'll just say cout endl for end line. All right, so now what we can do to create the total is we can say total equals price times quantity. So, but make sure you spell it right. Now for the second part of this program, let's create a receipt that will display the results. So we'll type this after we calculate the total. So let's create a cout statement and we'll write something such as item, or you can type in like item name, whatever you want. Doesn't matter too much what you type here. So we'll type in item and let's add an end line keyword after this. And it's going to be a similar process for the other inputs that we have. So price, and then price. So you don't have to type these strings exactly the way that I do. This is just how I would create like some sort of bill or receipt, but you know, do whatever you want here. So perhaps for a quantity, I'll just put X for like a multiplier of some sort. Like you bought this at this price times however many you bought. So we'll say quantity here, then end line. All right, and then we will say cout. Your total is, then I'll just add the dollar sign or whatever currency you're using, you can add that here. Total, endl. All right, it all looks good. Let's run this. All right, what item do you want to buy? Bag of chips. Potato chips. What is the price for each? How about $1.05? How many do you want to buy? I feel like 5 bags of potato chips. All right, item, bag of potato chips. Price, 105 times 5, your total is $5.25. I forgot to add the dollar sign for the price, but it would still work regardless without it. I'm just very particular with small details like that for output. But yeah, that is some of the basics for accepting user input. If you would like a copy of this program, I'll post it as source code in the comments down below. So feel free to try this out for yourself. And if you, you know, practice with this or generate some output, post it in the comments down below as well, because I'd like to see what you came up with basically. Or if you'd like to create your own version of this, feel free to post that as well. But yeah, that is how to accept user input using C++. Hey you, if you enjoyed this lesson, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.